Hey everyone! In this video, we will explain the basic functions of contour cutting in the Variable Data Wizard. We'll create a simple design with text and use a text replacement file to demonstrate how to quickly get started with VDW. With the job loaded into the queue, right-click on the job and select Variable Data Wizard. There will be text on the graphic, so select the text icon found with the tools on the left. Next, I'm going to click and drag a box to represent the maximum area I want the text to take up. If the replacement text is longer, it automatically scales to enable the text to remain within the bounding box. Before typing, set the attributes of the text by changing the font to Brush Script, the font height to 0.79 inches, with a center alignment. Finally, type the words Partner and Partner. Now select the text and set the color to white and give it a stroke of 0.02. With the Select tool, select both objects either by selecting around the objects or selecting the heart, holding the Shift key, and selecting the text. Align them horizontally and vertically by going to the Layout menu, selecting the Alignment and Spacing submenu, then the Align to Page Size submenu, and selecting Centers horizontally. You can also use the key combination Alt plus Home. To center the objects vertically, go through the same menu path and select Centers Vertically. You can also use the key combination Alt and End. Now to rotate the text. Click on an empty area on the page to deselect the objects and select the text alone. Give the text a rotation of minus 45 degrees by going to the rotation field found at the top and typing in minus 45. Then click the Enter key. Select both the heart and text again and select the Contour Cut tool on the left. Ensure the inside-outside box and the bitmap frame box at the top are left unticked. Confirm the offset value field found at the top in the middle is set to 0. Click Apply on the top right. The monochrome filter dialog will appear to set the threshold value. This determines where the cut line is set depending on the monochrome values of the graphic. The heart has a transparent background, and with a threshold value set to 249, you'll get the following result after clicking OK. Note the distance the cut line is from the heart. If you prefer a closer cut line, with the Contour Cut tool, click Apply again. The monochrome filter dialog will reopen. This time, put in a value of 145 and click OK. See how the contour cut line is now closer to the heart. Next, we're going to set up the text substitution. Open the Variable Data Wizard dialog by clicking on the VDW icon in the bottom left. The text recognized to be replaced is shown here on the right. In this example, it's Partner and Partner. To the right, select Replace in the drop-down list. Tick the Replace Data file at the top left of the dialog, then browse to the text file that has the text substitutions. This text file has one entry per line. The number of copies shown here is 16, which matches the number of entries in the selected text file. If you apply the text by clicking on the work area and did not use the text bounding box, you'll need to constrain the text so longer names don't extend beyond the intended design. To do this, tick the box for Use Original Text as Maximum Length found at the lower left of the dialog. This will ensure the replacement text will not extend farther than the text you input when creating the design. In this case, it was Partner and Partner. Click Next. In the following dialog, tick the box, I want to customize the output material size. This will allow you to set your own output size of the sticker. Click Next. The text substitution dialog will open up with the names from the replacement file. You can make changes to the entries by selecting the entry and editing the text in the field at the top. Click OK, and the files with cut lines will be sent to the queue and be ready to print. The jobs with replaced text and contour cut lines are now ready to print and cut. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please reach out to us at any time. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering all of CAD Link's products.